today I'll go for the next part of the solution. Here I want to express what are the factors affecting to gas in liquid solution. So here the solute is gas and the solvent is liquid. So what are the factors affecting to it? Number one is your nature. Number two is your temperature. Number three is your pressure. So those are the three factors affecting to the solubility of gas in liquid solution. So first of all, what is the nature? The nature of solubility depend upon how the carbon dioxide soluble in water, how the carbon nitrogen soluble in water, how the oxygen soluble in water. The solubility of carbon dioxide, nitrogen, oxygen, all are different in water, because the nature of carbon dioxide, the nature of oxygen, nature of nitrogen are different for the solvent water. Similarly, we'll go for the temperature. We'll express this also by using the Henry's law. Next, we'll go for the temperature effect. So the temperature is inversely proportional to solubility of gas in liquid solution. So how this temperature is inversely proportional to solubility of gas in liquid solution? Let's say you are taking a container, and this container consists some amount of water, let's say, and here some amount of oxygen is dissolved inside it. So that is called gas in liquid solution. Now let here the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. If I want to increase the temperature from 25 to, let's say, 35 degrees Celsius, then what will happen? The oxygen molecules which is present inside it start to get more temperature, and we know the temperature increases means molecular interaction decreases. And if the molecular interaction decreases, then the oxygen molecules can easily move away from the solution. So on increasing the temperature, some amount of gaseous molecules start to move away from the solution, and when the solute amount decreases, then the solubility decreases. So I can say on increasing the temperature, solubility decreases. Now we'll go for the pressure effect. So what is the effect of pressure for gas in liquid solution? The pressure is directly proportional to solubility. Pressure is directly proportional to solubility. So how this pressure is directly proportional to solubility of gas in liquid solution? Similarly, let's say you are taking a container, and this container consists of some amount of, let's say, water. And you are taking a gas cylinder here. This gas cylinder consists, let's say, oxygen. And you are maintaining the temperature, let's say, constant is 25 degrees Celsius. Now, you are just dissolving some amount of oxygen here under a pressure of, let's say, 1 atm. So let's say under a pressure of 1 atm, you are just putting the oxygen here. Let the amount of oxygen dissolved, let is 0.1 mole. If I want to increase the pressure from 1 atm to 2 atm, then I can observe that the amount of oxygen dissolved will be more. Why? Because on increasing the pressure, the oxygen molecules come closer to each other, and when the oxygen molecules come closer to each other, it can occupy more oxygen, and for that reason, the solubility of oxygen inside the solution start to increase. So I can say the pressure is directly proportional to solubility. Remember, there is a difference between the pressure and partial pressure. What is the partial pressure? Partial pressure means the individual component pressure in the mixture. Here I am taking the oxygen and the water. So what are the individual components here? Oxygen and the water. The pressure of oxygen present here and the pressure of oxygen present here, both are different. The pressure of oxygen present inside the mixture can be called as partial pressure of oxygen. And by taking this concept of pressure, temperature, and we'll explain the nature also by using the Henry's law. So what is the Henry's law statement for the gas in liquid solution? So this Henry's law statement indicates the partial pressure of gas in a liquid solution is directly proportional to the mole fraction of gas in a liquid solution. So that is the Henry's law. The partial pressure of gas in a liquid solution is directly proportional to mole fraction of gas in a liquid solution. If I want to express it, we know the mole fraction of gas is equal to number of moles of gas divided by number of moles of gas plus number of moles of solvent. And here the solvent is liquid. So I can say mole fraction is directly proportional to number of moles of gas. So I can say here the mole fraction is directly proportional to number of moles of gas. So if inside the solution the gas number of moles is more, that indicates the mole fraction is more. And we know if mole fraction is more, that indicates we are applying more pressure. If we are applying more pressure, then indicates that the pressure of the solute inside the gas is also increases. If the pressure inside the gas is increases, then mole fraction is more. If mole fraction is more, then I can say pressure of partial pressure of gas and mole fraction of gas are directly proportional, and which was explained by Henneris. So that is called Henneris law, that is partial pressure of gas is directly proportional to mole fraction of gas. And if I want to remove this proportional, then I can use a constant, that is partial pressure of gas is equal to kh into mole fraction of gas. This kh is a constant, and this constant is called Henneris constant. So this is called Henneris constant. Now if I want to plot a graph, partial pressure versus mole fraction, then how this graph will become? If I want to plot a graph here, let's say this is the mole fraction of gas and I want to take the partial pressure of gas, it indicates they are directly proportional. That indicates the graph will be like this, it comes a straight line, because if I want to increase the partial pressure of gas, automatically the mole fraction of gas increases. So I can say they are directly proportional. So here what will be the kh? Kh is a Henneris constant, and that will be your mole fraction of, that will be is your partial pressure of gas divided by mole fraction of gas. So what should be the unit of it? We know mole fraction do not have an unit, so its unit is the pressure unit. So you can say its unit is atm or bar or millibar, like that. So kh is directly proportional, kh is directly proportional to the temperature. How the kh is directly proportional to temperature? Because if I want to increase the temperature, the kh value is also increases. So how the temperature and kh are related to each other? We know kh is inversely proportional to mole fraction of gas, because if I want to write here kh, that indicates that it is inversely proportional to mole fraction of gas. And we know if the mole fraction of gas is less, that indicates that the solubility is less. And already I told what is the relation between the temperature and solubility. Temperature is inversely proportional to solubility for gas in liquid solution. So now I told if mole fraction of gas is less, then kh is more. Now I told if mole fraction of gas is less, that indicates that number of moles of gas inside the solution is less. So that indicates mole fraction of gas is less, means solubility is less. If the solubility is less, then temperature is more. So that indicates from these two concepts, I can say, that is solubility is less, so I can say here the kh is directly proportional to temperature. Again I am repeating here, how is it? We know mole fraction of gas and kh are inversely proportional. We know mole fraction of gas means individual moles of gas divided by total moles. So if individual moles of gas in solution is less, then solubility is less. And if the solubility is less, then temperature is more. That indicates that kh and temperature are directly proportional. So I can say if temperature is more, then kh is more. And if kh is more, then what will be its solubility? So I can say there is a relation between the temperature and kh, that is temperature is directly proportional to kh. So if I want to take these two, so I can write now kh is inversely proportional to solubility. So we are getting the two concepts from the Henneris law, that is number one, kh is directly proportional to temperature, number two, kh is inversely proportional to solubility. Is it? Let I will take one example, and we want to find out how it is related. That is, for the first one I told about the nature. Let's say you are taking the helium, you are taking the hydrogen, you are taking the nitrogen at 25 degrees Celsius. What will be the kh value for the helium? It will be approximately will be 147. And what is the value of H2? at 25 degree, what is the Ks value of H2 at 25 degree Celsius? It will be approximately 69, and that will be approximately 76.66. So let's say I'll write 77. And here I want to express all the Ks value in the unit of kilobar. So let's say all the unit I have expressed in the unit of kilobar. So I told what is the relation between the Ks and solubility. They are inversely proportional. So that indicates that here the Ks value of helium is more by keeping the temperature constant. And after that the nitrogen, then is your helium, then is your hydrogen. So what will be the solubility order? I can say the solubility of helium will be less, then which will become nitrogen, then which will become hydrogen. So that indicates that here the solubility decreases. Solubility increases. This is the solubility increases. The helium will be less soluble, nitrogen will be more soluble than helium, and hydrogen will be more soluble than helium and nitrogen. Similarly, if I want to take, let's say I am taking the helium at 25 degrees Celsius and I will take the same helium at 30 degrees Celsius, then what will be the Ks value at 30 degrees Celsius? We know Ks and temperature are directly proportional. If the 25 degrees Celsius Ks value is 147, then at 30 degrees Celsius the Ks should be greater than 147. So that indicates that if the Ks increases, then the solubility decreases. So I can say at 30 degrees Celsius helium will be less soluble than in comparison to solubility of helium at 25 degrees Celsius. So this is about the explanation of Henry's law. On the next class, I will go for its application and limitation.